In this screencast, I'm going to show you an example of a simple two-way if-then in VBA. What we're going to do here is, first of all, create a sub, and then secondly, we're going to create a function to do this. But this sub or function is going to add 20 to every positive number and subtract 20 from every negative number. And we're doing this in a single cell, so we're going to run that sub on cell A1. If it's positive, like it is in this first one, it's going to add 20. If it's negative, it's going to subtract 20. Before I get going, I always like to write a flow diagram. We always start, and then in this case, we need to input our x. The next step is this if then, is x greater than 0? So is x positive? If that's true, then we add 20 to x. So we're redefining x as the old x plus 20. If that's false, then x is going to be the old x minus 20. We then need to close everything up, and then we output x, and then we end. So that's the flow chart. So let's go into Visual Basic. The first thing I'm going to do is to sub add subtract 20. And then we need to dim x as a double, so that's what we're going to extract from that cell, and x is going to be defined as our active cell value. We go back to our flow chart. We've input x, that's the active cell value, and now we're going to put in this conditional. It's called a two-way if-then because if it's true, we do one thing, and if it's false, we do another. The one-way if-then is when it's true, we only do one thing. So that's why it's called a one-way, but this is called two-way because we're doing something if it's true, and we're doing something if it's false. So if x is greater than 0, then x equals x plus 20. For the two-way, we put an else, x equals x minus 20. And then we end if, and we now output this, so we're going to say the active cell value is equal to x. So let's do this. I'm going to leave the cursor somewhere in the sub. I'm going to just put in a number 45 here and highlight that active cell. I'm going to go here, press F8 to start, and you see that it takes up 45. That's the active cell value. If it's positive, which it is, then we do this line of code. So when I press F8, it's x is redefined as 65, and then we end the if active cell value equals x. So what that did is it replaced the active cell value with the new x, the 65, and then I end sub. Let's just verify that this works with a negative number. I'm going to do Alt F8 to bring up the module, and I'm going to run that module, and in fact, it worked. It subtracted 20 from that. Let's now just modify this slightly. Let's say I had a bunch of values, 23, 10, negative 17, maybe another one up here, 45, negative 9. And I wanted to create a function so that I could just put into a neighboring cell and I could drag that down to quickly compute, either subtracting 20 from all the negative values or adding 20. I'm going to go back to my sub. We can use the sub as a baseline, and I'll just copy this, control copy, and somewhere down here I'll paste. And now I'm just going to change this to a function, and I'm just going to call this modify. When you're converting a sub to a function, you notice that when I change the sub to function, it put in an end function. It changed the sub to function. And there's just a few more things that we have to do. We're going to have an argument to this. So I'm just going to put a dummy variable A, and that's going to be an active cell, or we could actually use even a range in some functions, but not this one. We just want to use a single cell. And then I'm dimming x as a double. X is going to be a.value. And now we need an output to this. So instead of here, I used to have active cell dot value equals x. Now I'm going to say modify, because the name of the function is always the output. So I'm going to say modify equals x. And now I'm going to show you how to troubleshoot this. You can't just press F8 to step through functions, but what you can do is put a breakpoint somewhere, and then you go into here, we type in modify, and it recognizes that. We put in this cell, and when I press enter, because I put that breakpoint in, it'll just stop there, and now I can press F8. So let's make sure this is working. It picked up X as -9. Now we press F8, so X, which is -9, is not greater than 0, so we're going to compute this, so we're going to subtract 20, and then we end the if, and then modify, which is the output to the function, is now going to be -29, and when we end this function, it spits out the value of that into that cell. Now I can easily drag this down, and it brings that modify function down to all of those B1 to B6 values. So that is how you can work with two-way if-thens in VBA.